This video will be about the Warsaw Pact. So, the Warsaw Pact was a counterpart of NATO. It was a collective defense treaty signed in Warsaw, Poland. That's why it's called the Warsaw Pact. It was founded on 1955, and it was dissolved on July 1st, 1991. The headquarters of the Warsaw Pact, however, were in Moscow, Soviet Union back then. Members were Albania, Bulgaria, Czechoslovakia, East Germany, Hungary, Poland, Romania, and of course the Soviet Union, and I made a mistake in my last video, Yugoslavia, or Serbia, Greater Serbia was not part of the Warsaw Pact. The first supreme commander of the Warsaw Pact was Ivan Konev, and the last one was Pyotr Lushev. Of course, the Warsaw Pact was kinda like forced alliance by the Soviet satellite states, countries occupied by the Soviet Union after World War II. They basically had to join the Warsaw Pact. They had no other choice. And basically in the beginnings, Western European countries like France and Great Britain and the USA, I know the USA is not a Western European country, but they were afraid of a new German uprising, that some evil dictator would come to power again, and then World War III would happen, and crazy stuff. So the Allies, they said, let's found NATO also to keep Germany down, and also to keep the Russians out. And the Soviet Union said, yeah, let's found a counterpart of that, the Warsaw Pact, to keep Germany down and to keep the Americans out. And of course you can say that they kept the Eastern Europeans down, because in my opinion, I believe that most Eastern Europeans or 3 million. And NATO had a military personnel of over 2 million, but the thing is, the Soviet Union themselves estimated that NATO had a military personnel of 3.6 million. By different sources. Yeah, and of course, NATO and Western European countries, they were afraid that one day the Warsaw Pact, so their troops could invade Western Europe, and the main battlefield of this conflict would, of course, be Germany. Yeah. You maybe know the term Iron Curtain. Iron Curtain was the separation between East and West Germany, and it basically symbolizes the border between the communist Eastern Bloc and the capitalist Western Bloc. Yeah, and yeah, what else can I tell you about it? Yeah, back to Germany. Maybe I don't know if that's important, but Stalin suggested in 1952 that Germany should be reunited with all their lost territories and so on, but they had to promise that they would stay neutral in case a war between the Soviet Union and the USA broke out. Yeah, and somehow it didn't happen. According to my research, the Allies, the Americans, and of course the French and the Britons, they didn't want that Germany will be independent again, because they feared, yeah, a German uprising again. Yeah, of course. Back to the Warsaw Pact. After the dissolvement of the Soviet Union in 1991, there were still large equipment and also nuclear weapons left in former states of the Warsaw Pact and former states of the Soviet Union. And yeah, Ukraine maybe you could say they were not really a member of the Warsaw Pact, because they belonged to the Soviet Union at that time, but the Soviet Union had nuclear weapons in the Ukraine, and in the 90s they made the Ukraine, they made lots of contracts with Russia and NATO about their nuclear weapons, what to do with them, and somehow it wasn't really solved this problem. But I think that now, with the outbreak of a Russian-Ukrainian war, the Ukraine probably regrets that they don't have any nuclear weapons, because if they had, Russia would definitely not invite the Ukraine. I'm not taking sides here. I'm not for Ukraine or Russia here. I'm just giving my opinion. Yeah. was basically a military alliance made out of Soviet satellite states, territories, Eastern European countries that were occupied by the Soviet Union after World War II. And it was the counterpart of NATO. NATO was kind of, you could say, like the protector of Western capitalism and democracy, and the Warsaw Pact was